Hello everyone. It's my great pleasure to welcome you all to the University of Manchester and to the amazing surroundings of our Whitworth Hall for this very important ceremony. First, I want to congratulate you all on your hard work and amazing achievements, particularly in the face of notable adversity. You have come through COVID, industrial action, and no doubt many other trials and tribulations, but you've all met, adapted to, and overcome challenges not known to any of us previously. This makes your achievements this year all the more remarkable. The skills, knowledge, and experience you've developed during your time with us have given you a strong platform to not only build your career and achieve your goals, but also to succeed in the face of any obstacles you might meet in the future. We're also delighted to see so many friends, family members, and supporters here. And we want to thank you for the support that you have given to our students during their studies, which has been so important to their success. You can be extremely proud of what they've achieved, and I can assure you that colleagues across the schools and departments are also proud. So graduands, I would like you to stand, please, and give a big round of applause to thank all those who have supported you. We're delighted, of course, that you made the wise decision to come and study at the University of Manchester. And you chose to make your mark on the future, not only for yourselves, but for the greater good of society and the environment. We were the first university in the United Kingdom to set social responsibility as a core goal. And we encourage our students to engage in transformational activities, both in their studies and beyond, to help you to stand out, to consider your place in the world, and to make a difference. Throughout the course of your studies and life here in Manchester, you'll have gained the skills and knowledge to find success and become responsible leaders of tomorrow. I'm sure you're all glad to see the end of assignments for now, but the planning, research, critical thinking, and writing skills you deployed and nurtured will be of great value in the world of work, or indeed perhaps during further study. The way you've balanced your commitment to academic life with other interests, and there are a fair few other interests in Manchester, will help you find a work-life balance as your career and your future unfolds. And of course, we must not forget the strong, supportive friendships and relationships you've forged here, which I hope you will sustain for many years to come. So we cannot overstate the importance of your achievements, given the challenging times we've all faced, not only as a community, but as citizens of the world. As you reflect on your past and plan for the future, perhaps think of the university's motto, Cognitio Sapientia Humanitas, knowledge, wisdom, humanity. We encourage you to boldly pursue new ideas and apply your knowledge and skill to the benefit of others. With these commitments in mind, you'll continue to build on the success you've enjoyed in your studies and make a difference to the world around you. Over the last 12 months, the university has seen some notable successes. In the National Research Excellence Framework, 93% of the research in the university was assessed as world-leading or internationally excellent. But we care not only about academic excellence, and we were particularly pleased that in the global rankings of the impact of universities judged against the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals, we were top in the UK, top in Europe, and second in the world. Thank you. This achievement shines a light on our core values and recognises what we can achieve together, delivering benefits for wider society. We're also delighted to present our eighth cohort of Stellify Achievers. This programme offers a unique and personalised set of activities to help you develop the distinctive attributes of a University of Manchester student. We're proud that some of you here today have taken part in Stellify. But we also are grateful to you because you've helped to change and shape the university. We're continually changing, hopefully for the better. So today is as much about honouring you for your contributions as it is about celebrating your success. Your job prospects, having studied here, are enviable because employers all around the world recognise the value of a University of Manchester education. Today is an important milestone, and you should, of course, celebrate your success. But we hope that this is just the beginning of the journey and of your association with the University of Manchester, and not the end. Your return on investment continues well beyond today. Our career service will continue to offer you support and help for 3 years, and you can continue to use our libraries. We're proud to have the largest alumni community of any campus-based university in the UK, with over 500,000 graduates living and working in more than 190 countries. The Alumni Association will help you to connect with that community and remain in contact with the university. As alumni of the university, you will be forever part of this institution, and you can help future students in many ways, as ambassadors, perhaps student placements in your future places of work, in employment, and directly in the development of the university. So we sincerely hope that today will not be your last contact with the University of Manchester. Our doors will always be open to you. Thank you. I'm now very pleased to introduce Samantha Bronheim, Union Affairs Officer for the Students' Union. Sam has recently graduated in zoology from the University of Manchester and acts as the primary student representative for our Students' Union. She chairs the union's trustee board and is a governor on the university's board. Sam has lived around the world, in London, Spain, the USA, but I hate to say it, most importantly, Manchester. Sam.
When I was first invited to speak as a commencement speaker, I was very excited but also very nervous. As Nancy said, I only graduated last year from the same institution, so I feel underqualified to bestow any wisdom on my peers. So instead, I chose the next best thing, which is to read a eye-rollingly cheesy poem that hopefully will stay with a lot of you for the rest of the day. In the heart of a city bold and grand, where history and innovation go hand in hand, the University of Manchester stands tall as a beacon of knowledge, inspiring one and all. Oh, graduates of this remarkable place, you've conquered challenges with grace. Through the trials of a pandemic's might, you emerged as warriors, shining bright. In lecture halls and libraries, ideas bloomed, seeking wisdom's treasures as exams loomed. But fate had a twist as the world turned gray. COVID-19 arrived, disrupting your way. Yet in this storm, you found your light, adapting swiftly and embracing the fight. Virtual classrooms, Zoom calls, and screens, you thrived together, united in dreams. From Fallowfield's vibrant student streets to the cobbles of Oxford Road where progress meets, from Curry Mile scents to Castlefield's charm, Manchester's embrace was never far from warm. Through lockdowns and masks, you held your ground. Graduates of Manchester, you astound. With resilience and courage, you faced the storm until you triumphed in every form. So here's to the late night study sessions when caffeine-fueled minds would lead to digressions, and in lecture halls where attention sometimes wanes, professors were armed with puns causing groans and pains. And when the deadlines approached, anxiety grew. You relied on takeaways, as cooking skills were few. But with countless pizza boxes piled up high, you dined like champions with a greasy sigh. So as you step forth into the world anew, remember the strength that you've carried through. The bonds you've forged, the lessons you've learned, are a legacy of resilience forever earned. As you move on and venture ahead, keep Manchester close on the path that you tread. The knowledge you've gained and the friendships you've formed will guide you through life as the world transforms. I would hate to keep you from your celebrations with my silly rhymes and puns of appreciation, so I will end now full of admiration and wishing you all sincere congratulations.
Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to our wonderful city of Manchester. It is my great pleasure to say a few words about the School of Engineering and talk a little about the importance of training engineers, project managers, and computer scientists to tackle some of the world's most important societal challenges. Firstly, it is with great pride that as a Mancunian myself, I am able to represent our school and share with you some insights about what we do. As many of you will know, our student and staff community is diverse and inclusive, with students joining us from around the world to study engineering, project management, and computer science. We deliver programs in areas from mechanical engineering to advanced manufacturing, and this year we're starting up a new multidisciplinary program in robotics. Our academics and technical staff also drive cutting-edge research, both with postgraduate students and teams of researchers. This ranges from taking a systems approach to the design and control of large capacity wave energy devices, or improving offshore renewable energy designs to enable deep water siting of wind turbines. And we have research in collaboration with industrial partners, from making our electricity network more resilient with National Grid, to more locally focused activities, working with Greater Manchester Combined Authorities to help them cut our CO2 emissions in the region. This connection between our expertise and our region takes us back to the 1800s. The university originated in response to the engineering challenges of the Industrial Revolution. 1824, on the university logo, was the date of the formation of the Institute of Mechanics, and the university soon followed. Manchester was the birthplace of the engineering discipline in universities. But as the birthplace of the Industrial Revolution, this also initiated one of today's biggest global challenges, that of climate change. So it is particularly fitting that here in Manchester, we are tackling climate change through major projects such as those relating to the circular economy or cutting material use in manufacturing, to decarbonising our energy system through the interdisciplinary research in the Tyndall Centre for Climate Change. Our teaching staff are also continually innovating, for instance, sending engineering kits around the world during the pandemic to ensure students could continue to develop their practical skills. And many of you will have gained skills relating to global grand challenges through learning how to design new devices, systems, or processes as part of projects supervised by academics who are at the forefront in their fields. We champion contributions such as academics like Dr. Kilu Yanusa-Keltungo, who was named as our Teacher of the Year in 2023, and who, along with others, helps to support our students in activities such as the IMECI Regional Design Challenge, where our student teams charted up a clean sweep of awards across all categories that were entered. Akilu is just one example of our exceptional staff who teaches skills and knowledge that will help you to make important contributions to address major engineering, environmental, and societal challenges throughout your lives. You have trained with us to work in professions that will only become more important as society takes stock of the great challenges that the world faces today. During your time here, you will have become more curious, develop new problem-solving skills, and learnt how to be critical, analytical, and inquiring. But as you will hopefully now realise, our university is here to provide you with experiences and skills that you can take with you into the wider community, industry, and society, to play your part in building a better world, in making a difference. So, on behalf of all of my colleagues across the School of Engineering, I'd first like to thank your family, friends, and significant others for all of their support, and congratulate you on your hard work, enthusiasm, commitment, and achievement at reaching this important milestone, and wish you every success for the future and with making a difference in our world. Thank you.
President and the Vice Chancellor, on behalf of the Senate of the University, I present to you for the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Ashraf Muslim Abn Al-Ghami. Kiprian Berbatov. Damian John Crosby. Anupam Day. Babatunde Adwale Dusumu. Mohamed Hassan. Edmund Ireland. Karen Lee. Chunshu Liu. Shuwei Lu. Oliver Marshall. Daniel Massey. Hong Bo Mo. Saide Telier Purashraf Runbane. Justina Salachna. Fatima Shabazi. Wei Sun. And for the degree of Master of Philosophy, Management of Projects, Nkemjika Anslem Onuchuku. And Fiona Margaret Spencer. Okay. Oh, sorry. And for the degree of Master of Science, Advanced Manufacturing Technology and Systems Management, Ananta Krishnan Ramesh. And Kumar Satyam. And in Construction Project Management, Musa Sulaiman Mohammed Al-Rajdi. Apurva Arun Kumar Jaiswar. Yanchi Zhou. And in Management of Projects, Yan Zhao Chen. Tse Gao. And Yan Bing Yang. And in Project Management, Craig Anthony Cox. And for the award of Postgraduate Diploma in Engineering Project Management, Mohammed Nasruddin Abdaurov Abdelrazek. And for the degree of Master of Engineering, Mechanical Engineering with Honors, Natasha Diana Binti Abdul Rahman. Mohammed Afik Bin Abdullah. Yasmin Abusat. Long Muhammad Nor Afik. Noim Ahmed. Marwan Mahmoud Farak Ali Ahmed Sakr. Adil Altaf. Theodore Benedict. Zainur Fardous Bain Jainul. Mohammed Anas bin Mohammed Hussein. Mohammed Raimi bin Mocht Afandi. Mohammed Shazwan Hadi bin Murad, Karim Chahin, Jani Chan, Kwai E. Runei Chua, Dhruv Rajesh Dulani, Minam Elahai, Tan Yuan Li, Ahmad Harris Irfan bin Fakruel Arifan, Matthew Flanagan, Tepei Goto, Matthew Hatcroft, Tamunu Tunyai Harold Horsfall, Dynan Jennings, Chui Wen Kong, Finn Knopp, Matthew Kurodamanil Kushi, Sean Feng Li, Zhao Cheng Li, Jia Ying Sakari Lim, Kaizuran Bin Mazlan, Bobak Bruka Mivekchi, Muhammad Zakir bin Mocht Rusmand, Lauren Mooney, James Christopher Orr, Anna Popesca, Shakilur Rahman, Salik Rashid, Alia Farhana Binti Ruzali, Fraser Sims, Dhruv Singh, Randip Singh, Mimi Chin Sin So, Tate Thompson, Matas Vilimas, Thomas Wadsworth, Aidan Williams, Mohammed Zaim bin Zahari, Irshaduddin Ibad bin Zaidi, Ariwan Zering, Heji Zhang, Hao Cheng Zhao, and in mechanical engineering, nuclear engineering with honors, Hussein Yusap, Piotr Tomasz Kukulski. Benjamin Manasse. And Melissa Louise Pace. And in mechanical engineering with industrial experience with honors, Mohamed Abu Daka. Mohamed Javed Ahmed. Munib Ahmed. Thomas Ginty. Adnan Hussein. John Thomas Kadandot. Tawa Khan. Mariam Kutar. And Harry Witten Tozer. And in mechanical engineering with management with honors, Muhammad Akram bin Ahmad Azmi. Neisuchoku Ebenebe. Gustus Getraitis. Peter Gnapp. And Arian Matur. And for the degree of Bachelor of Engineering, Mechanical Engineering with Honors, Wabami Aluyoda Miladare Adeumi. Mohammed Ali S. Al Ibrahim. Turku Abdul Rahman Ol Al Subaya. Faisal Abdul Halim M. Al Tayeb. Utman Alwan Dawi. Walid Said M. Al Gamdi. Khalid Rashid Al-Hindi. Hanin Abdulaziz Al-Matami. Mohammed Faisal Hussein Mirza Al-Shamsi. Zaid Jamil Amuri. Arbek Angin. Nela Amir Arain. Aman Vir Badual. Conrad Bennett. Benita Elizabeth Benoy. Adil Bilal. Arda Boskurt. Bolu Wasafe Bolu Waduru Braithwaite.
Cameron Bice. Faith Lydia Cookin. June Denk. Ahmed Elzugibi. Habiba Gamal Farid Mohamed Emara. Daniel Wenway Evans. Basil S. Zach Foster. Epani Tato Gwamba. Muaz Siafie bin Hafizuddin. Rim Hamruni Kasses. Mohamed Yusuf Hassan. Karam Hashem. Elijah Allen Horich. Yobosa Igbineweka. Naveen John Kanyantara. Irma Kellis. Seth Kirkup. Brandon Choke Hay Low. Wei Yang Liu. Sushu Liu. Samuel Rhys Llewellyn. Pavlo Lutsai. Nazifa Manir. Elias McLaughlin. Clementine Mitford. Abdallah Mohammed Abdallah Zakaria Salem. Ramiz Muhammad. Nishwa Nawaz. Zakari Daniel Luis Okmur. Tolulope Onyedikachi Osinubi. Ujibien Kosova Osmani. Emir Nevzat Uskan. Humayt Yusuf Gulam Hussein Kasem. George Thomas Reiner. Tyler James Rogers. Cameron Sunbrook. Haris Rian Sardar. Xinyu Shao. Judith Sharma. Sara Jia Wen Tan. William Taylor. Uku Rasmus Tiedemann. Elif Duru Turk. Kirtan Upadhyaya. Chi Wang. Shilong Wang. Harry Ward. Joshua Wilson. Dingyan Ye. And in mechanical engineering, nuclear engineering with honors, Khalifa Faris Ahmed Mohammed Al-Mesabi. Jivan Segdev. And in mechanical engineering with management with honors, Osama Amal Abdel Wahed. Walid Khaled Abdel Rahman Al Razem. Ahmad Maher Ahmad Khurani. Rui Biao Hu. Dev Mistry. Egemen Mungan. Alex Navarro Alberti. Seylin Orhan. Yuyang Qian. From the School of Natural Sciences and for the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Anna Evelyn Denman. And Olwen Stack. From the School of Engineering for the degree of Master of Science, Advanced Process Integration and Design with Accreditation, Ashutosh Karkare. And for the degree of Master of Engineering, Mechanical Engineering with Honors, Muhammad Moyen Tadayon Chakharsugi. And for the degree of Bachelor of Engineering, Mechanical Engineering with Management Honors, Ibrahim Alutaibi. And for the degree of Master of Science, Nuclear Science and Technology, Sarah Holhead. and for the degree of Doctor of Philosophy in Nuclear Engineering, Ioannis Pantelis.
Graduates of the University of Manchester, please stand. Make sure your tassel is on the left. Could all guests and supporters please stand now and join me in a big round of applause again. Well done, everybody. Woo! University of Manchester, congratulations to every one of you on your amazing achievements, and we want to wish you every success in your future careers and every happiness in your future lives. But don't forget us, come back. Now is the time to celebrate. I now declare this ceremony closed. Thank you, everybody.